All right, good afternoon. This is Themen 0613 with a Dominion small game match between Rosie Rose and Aglet. This is in the small games. I forget the name of the group. It's actually the group I'm in, so I should know the name. Let me pull that up real quick. But it is a small games match in the... I'm pulling it up. Here you can even see the standings. There we go. In the looks like we're in the Curry group. So Aglet is 1-3. Just played his first match, I believe, yesterday against Super Nick. And Rosie is 4-4. As I mentioned, I'm also in this group here at 5-3. I went 3-1 against Rosie with a 2-2 draw against Super Nick. I would still need to play Aglet. And then we still got one player, Marsh Kalk family, still left to play all their matches. So. I guess if I want to win the group, I'm probably rooting for a Rosie win here, since I have the tiebreak. If I want to make the playoffs, which is top two, I'm probably rooting for an Aglet win. So I'm kind of mixed. Just hope I get to see some good games here. And, you know, two players I'm fairly familiar with. I've played both them a couple of times now, and, you know, are pretty familiar names now, I think, in the community. We will have KDG joining in a couple minutes. I just finished up some work stuff. Should be on any moment. So hopefully, you know, he'll be able to provide some good insight at a little higher level play than I'm at. So as we look at the first kingdom, we have Way of the Mouse. So the Way of the Mouse card looks like it is Camel Train. So not all that great, but could be useful at times, I guess. Looking at some of the other cards here, I mean, we have familiars to give curses, if that's going to be relevant. There's not much of way of trashing. In fact, I'm not sure I see anything in the way of trashing here. So that means familiars could be quite powerful if you can give curses. Particularly Kiln, because Kiln might be a good way to gain familiars without needing as many potions. We have... I guess Artificer for gains. But yeah, it's going to be hard because there's not really a good way to thin. And there's not really a great way to draw either. I mean, in is a not really good draw because you have to discard, so... It's kind of an awkward kingdom. In terms of the opening here... Well, let's see, did they both get... they both did get 4/3s. I guess you have pouch, but that's probably not going to be super relevant here with the extra buys. Aglet does go straight for the potion. I think that's definitely reasonable here. I'm not really sure what else you want with 4 here. You want to go ill-gotten gains? I mean, but like, what do you... doing with ill-gotten gains, you're just giving people curses, but you have another copper you can't get rid of. I'm not sure how that works out. Oh, you're just going for a quick three pile. I don't know. I've never really, to be honest, I've never really played with ill-gotten gains. Maybe you're right that's accurate there. So we see that Rosie also matches with the potion. So they both start with the potion. So they both went the way that I thought. Yeah, I mean, I guess that might be viable. I'm not sure. I hadn't thought about that, Andy. Maybe. Oh, KHC, yeah. How are you doing?
Good. You're getting any feedback on this? I'm trying to find headphones.
I'm not right now, so I think we're okay. Good.
We can use that from
there. Yeah,
let's
I was...
look at this game.
Yeah, we just started about... We're in, like, turn three. There's a little debate in the chat. Halo wants to just go ill-gotten gains... which, to be honest, I've never really used much. I was just thinking familiar just to give curses, but he has a point that ill-gotten gains might be faster to deal out curses because there's no real way to trash.
Yeah, so IGG is a little awkward with another cursor because, so usually with IGG, what you want to do is you want to give out all the IGGs that empties IGG and curses, and then you buy up all the duchies.
Yeah.
But when there's another cursor on the board, you end up in this weird situation where there's more IGGs than curses. is.
Yeah.
So you have to, if your plan is three pile emptying on duchies, you also have to then empty out these IGGs that don't even give out a curse. So that can be a bit awkward.
Yeah. We did see, so they both started potion, and then Agla actually missed the familiar on his draw. He unfortunately
Yeah.
missed it. Looks like Rosie also. So Rosie managed to get two because she used Way of the Mouse to camel train and exile one, which is a good play. So Rosie's up, already up two familiars, which should be a pretty quick.
Yeah, that looks like a pretty huge lead on a board like this with no other trashing.
Yeah.
Since there's no trashing, crop rotation also looks, I mean, crop rotation's always amazing, but it looks extra amazing here.
Agreed, yeah, I think. And it also means the in could be a little more viable too, potentially, because you don't really mind the two discards. So I feel like in
No.
could be reasonably strong here.
Yeah, totally.
Just because, like you said, with no trashing and bloated decks, like you're probably gonna have two cards you could discard.
I don't like the venture buy, however.
Yeah, that definitely seems a little questionable. I mean, I don't really know. I don't think you're really gonna be going super heavy into the coppers. Like, I think you're gonna be doing some in, probably some artificer stuff.
I don't know how much I'm playing within, just because there aren't a ton of terminals I want to really play. Tracker's good, but I don't need a ton of them, and we have coin. Kiln is the
Yeah.
most attractive looking terminal. Like being, if you
Yeah.
could somehow early on like kiln familiars, like that would be huge. But I think probably I'm skipping in and just playing with like just a tracker or two as a terminal. I definitely want some artificers, if nothing else, because they're peddlers and peddlers are good. But
Yeah.
also because you can do stuff like exile. Like if you don't need to, you can exile a familiar and then with mouse,
Oh yeah, Rosie's
one
about to
plus
get
one
another
skip.
two familiar, three familiars,
Yeah.
so yeah, I
Wow.
think this is already pretty much over, honestly. I think it would be a pretty hard comeback, especially because Eglit just
This is
done it
close.
again.
Yeah.
That
So a
was
lot of the
pretty
time with
unfortunate.
potion, if you're opening for a familiar, you really want to open potion silver, just because, yeah,
Oh yeah,
this is
those
all
series
you
on.
need.
Yeah, and I think Aglet did open. Interestingly, Aglet was the one who opened Potion Silver. Rosie was the one who didn't open that.
Yeah, Rosie opened potion tracker.
And
But sometimes this game is not fair.
yeah, that was a very quick game one. So I still haven't decided who I'm rooting for because I'm actually in the same group in the small games, and I guess it depends whether I want to win the group or whether I want to make the playoffs. Who I'm rooting for here. So. Anyways, we have
Yeah, I'm
game
not
number two.
familiar with where they are in the tournament, so I'm not
So
sure.
there, so Aglet is 3-1, and then Rosie's 4-4.
Okay.
So, and it's five person groups. So, and then I'm sitting at 5-3 right now.
And what do like what would they need to score to make it out?
It's top two make it out. So, it's hard to tell because there's still one player that hasn't played at all yet.
Yeah, those scores sound a little unbalanced for right now.
No, it's fairly balanced. I mean, there've been no.
No, I meant like in terms of having played their matches.
Yeah. Anyways, so on to board two. Halo Andy doesn't like these boards.
I don't like this board much either. Let's
Yeah.
see. Catapult looks really strong as usual. Coven looks pretty
Especially
good.
because you could use Delve to gain extra silvers for catapults. Like,
Yep,
that
Delve looks
makes.
great.
Yeah, I agree. Like, catapult delving is a pretty decent combo because you could pretty quickly just get extra stuff to trash with it.
So on 5-2, Coven Delve seems fine. I'm also a little tempted by Delve Catapult Delve.
Did they, and they both got 5-2, which is interesting.
Yeah, so I'm guessing they're both gonna grab Covens and then curses are gonna fly pretty quickly. Coven seems good here. The only trashing is Catapult, which is terminal, and you'd much rather be trashing other cards than curse with Catapult.
Yeah.
I also
That's.
like going for Delve Catapult over Coven just because Coven is slow. The attack really hurts them from hitting numbers here because there's no draw
Yeah,
on the familiar.
so Rosie went with
Delve could
a
die because they
Duchess
still
instead of the
trash.
silver here, which seems kind of unnecessary. I mean, the effect isn't very good for Duchess. I feel like I'd much rather have a silver in this set.
Agreed. I think Duchess is just worse than Delve here.
We do see that Rosie gets a catapult, so we do have the first catapult bot. And now we'll see what Aglet gets here.
So,
I mean, I assume you want to go catapult.
On this board to me look like catapult and seer.
Yeah, because if you could catapult seer, then you could get a bunch of silvers. I would just, yeah, I'd be trying to catapult silvers basically as much as possible here.
Yep. Alternate cursing makes coven worse. Seer is amazing at drawing silver, and Delve gets you silvers basically for free. Yeah, Jaws pointing out the idea of Delve Seer, which is another option. I think I still like Delve Catapult.
Yeah, I agree. I think Delve Catapult Delve is pretty strong. Getting that early catapult attack out early is very good to trash, and then you can start going Seer. I think the covens are a little excessive here. I mean, I don't think you really need all these extra ones here. Like, the first one I think is fine. But I'm not sure the utility of getting beyond the first one. Because I think draw is going to become a problem. Yeah, and it kind of doesn't synergize super well with Seer.
Tactician. Okay, so there is a build here that gets thin with Catapult and uses Coven as payload and plays double tact. But it's a tricky build to pull off, and it seems a lot slower than the build that uses Seer for draw and Silver for economy.
Yeah.
Silvers are only cost 2 on this board.
So how did the... Ooh, so I just was checking the curse split, and it does look like it went 6-4? I can't tell where the last one is.
Yeah,
somebody
I
must have... Okay, yeah, I saw the exile. But we do see Aglet with the Seers, so Aglet should be able to draw better. So I think I just like him getting Silvers here. Yeah, Silver Seer is
yeah,
a good buy there.
Double tact is very awkward here. With only catapults at thin, it's a very hard build to set up. I'd be surprised if it could outpace the Seer deck.
Yeah.
The other thing is, it's going to be so hard to get rid of these curses. You're catapulting them one by one, or more likely you're catapulting treasure because you get the attack in.
Yeah.
So earlier, Rosie catapulted a estate rather than going for like the attack, and that let her hit 5, so she bought a tactician, which is okay. I don't really like tactician here, and I think I'd rather attack and then buy like another catapult or maybe 2 silvers, something like that at 4, rather than not attack and hit 5. Because you already have a bunch of 5s in your deck, and attacking is really good. Like,
yeah.
My draw here is Seer. The hand size attack is really going to hurt. I don't particularly like buying a village, just because you don't really have terminals. You have Duchess, which you shouldn't have, and you have Catapult.
Yeah. No, that makes sense. Yeah, I think the thing here that is an issue is that the coven's just too many. It's hard to play, because like you aren't getting draw. And I think on a board like this, you definitely want to have draw. Exactly.
So how many games have they played? This is a 4-game set?
Yeah, it's 4, and this is game 2. Yeah, so as I was saying, so Aglet is 3-1 right now, and Rosie's 4-4. Coven is a $5 delve that Seer can't draw. Yeah, pretty much at this point.
So Rosie now has this very awkward tactician where either she's making $2 and playing a tactician or making $4 and not playing a tactician. So I guess she delve here. And she really wants to.
Which. Yeah, I mean, I guess that's the one slight advantage of Duchess over Silver, is you could use it for the tactician, but... I guess that's an advantage, but yeah, it is pretty awkward, as you mentioned.
Look at all this money she can't play this turn. She wants to attack. She can get a good hand size attack in. Hopefully she can, because if you're playing the tactician deck, blockers are just curses.
Yeah, so it's definitely better to trash coppers here, I agreed at this point. You know, at least the first one. I mean, I think if I'm doing this deck, I think I want another catapult here even. Like, 'cause if you're gonna have the double attack deck, you'll have the actions. You wanna be catapulting as much as possible. Okay. So they did buy a catapult, so that's good. I'm not sure I've ever seen rocks, actually. To be honest. I don't even know what they do, I have to go look it up. I feel like it's pretty rare to ever need more than two catapults for anyone in a deck. Yeah. When you gain or trash this, gain a silver. Yeah, it seems kind of. It doesn't even look like rocks are that good. So, like, why do you have a split pile of a card that you don't really want? I mean, I guess they're a card you could just cat you keep catapulting, I guess. Yeah, I mean, honestly, like I said, I don't even think I've ever seen rocks come up as a pile. I mean, I'm curious to see if this deck from Rosie works out. Well, Eglit now is getting in on the, wait, did he not even do anything? He didn't even have, ooh, I didn't see what his hand was. Four curses and a copper. That would be why he didn't do anything. Yeah. I mean, I think you just have to keep going Sears, yeah. And the question is, like, I mean, I guess we're getting somewhat close to a pile out here with only three covens, four Sears. I'm not sure who's really ahead at this point. There's also Battlefield, so, like, at some point, buying just even like estates is worth three victory points at this point. Yeah, I agree. I mean, considering just, generally, I feel like especially at lower levels, sort of the landmarks get overplayed, and so I feel and people like to green early, so I'm a little surprised that neither player has greened yet. Yeah, I actually think this double attack deck, as much as we kind of said it's gonna be hard to pull together, it feels like it's actually starting to come together. I'm not. I don't know. What do you think about the mining villages there? Oh, did we lose you? You're muted, Cage. Yeah, just in case you didn't realize. Yeah, I mean, I guess the thought is at this point in the game, you can take the extra effect of mining village to get the plus two could actually be pretty useful, especially with the attack build. I guess that's the thought here. That's true. Yeah, I mean, this could be a nice turn for Rosie here with the tech coming in and a bunch of cards. Like, this is probably a province turn, and then probably should have enough to. I guess Aglet's gonna have a really good turn as well. So they're probably both province here. Nice, that was a good draw to get that. Ooh, two copper. I mean, I guess you only really need one for the trashing. Yeah, I mean, that's.
Here, I think this is like province duchess.
Yeah, that's the question, huh? Okay, duchess. Yeah, I was thinking, do you start? I mean, like, you could even just double duchy there and get two duchesses with it. Almost actually would have been better there.
I'm a little concerned about general space. She does have a bunch of villages, but I'd rather not take too many duchesses. I think I'd rather. Yeah, I'm not sure.
Yeah, I mean, just thinking like double duchies, more victory points because you get the two from battlefield. Trash. Yeah, definitely should have trashed the ducat there over the curse to get the attack off. I mean, I guess the attack in this case didn't matter.
But you don't know that. Like, Rosie didn't know that.
Yeah. Yeah, it's kind of awkward, though, that there, it might not end up even piling, so that's kind of awkward here. That but I guess the thing is, like, Aglet's not going to really have the chance to buy. Ooh, this is another big turn here. Yeah, it's true. Aglet didn't use Delve. Yeah, I mean, I think you want to try and double. You probably wanted. Yeah, if you pop both the villages, then you could double. I mean, I guess a province duchy here is also fine. I guess there's only two battlefield points, so yeah, getting double duchy would have been better.
Yeah, probably province estate.
Again, not trashing the ducat. So not trashing the ducat here is, again, I think, a mistake. I mean, and they just have the tactician, so that, you know, does give the extra action from that too, but.
Yep.
I still think I like Rosie's spot position here.
It's a close game. I think it's probably time for duchy here, as I thought. There's only four provinces left. There's one other season, so.
I think it's not really needed yet. I think you probably wait one more turn and go for a double. Like, if you get one province here, I guess without the tactician, it's a little rough for that, not drawing a tactician this turn.
Also, worth noting is Rosie could have been playing those duchesses into a leaf with the mining villages for a little bit of filtering.
Yeah, I don't know about this double. I mean, the double tack deck definitely came together better than I was expecting. And it does seem like it might end up winning this game.
Yeah, I still definitely think the Cedar deck is stronger, but the double tack deck is always more fun.
Ooh, not drawing the tact here for Rosie is gonna be an interesting decision here for Rosie. Yeah, this is rough. I don't think you could buy the province here as Rosie without attack coming in. Well, I mean, I guess Aglet doesn't have any extra buys, so yeah, with the coffer. I mean, you could province estate here actually. I don't think Aglet has any extra buys in his deck. I can't think of any. I don't think he, because Aglet doesn't have any ducats, so yeah, the province estate is actually really good here. Unfortunately, I don't think Rosie's gonna hit it either. No, Rosie's not gonna get it either. No, I like the province estate there because Aglet doesn't have. Yeah, because Aglet doesn't have any extra buys anywhere, so you're not at risk of Aglet catching up. And now, I mean, if you just Dutchie dance, you're fine. Like, you could just win this by Dutch. Like, I think you have to trash this and Dutchie dance here. I don't really know what the debate is here. Yep. And I think that's game. I mean, with attack coming in, you're definitely gonna get. Didn't play the tack? That is about to be a game-losing mistake. And Aglet resigns, even though I don't even think he needed to now. I mean, I think it was probably over anyways. Like, I think Rosie was just going to Dutchie at most turns, but...
Yeah, I mean, with no extra games, I don't think I would expect that.
But that is two to Rosie, so the group is definitely getting interesting now. I guess that's good for me to win the group, but it might make it harder for me to advance if I have a poor last two matches. So I don't know if it's good for me or not. Okay, this looks a lot more interesting than the last, a lot more fun than the last two. It looks like a lot of fun stuff going on. And stockpiles, yeah. That certainly seems reasonable. I don't really see what else. I mean, I guess.
You could do
Steward. Yeah. Yeah, I'm not sure. I guess. I mean, I feel like the Steward stockpile might be better, because I feel like Steward's going to transition better to getting the draw. Once you're trashing, whereas Priest, like, I don't think you're gonna have that many situations where you're trashing multiple cards in a game this time. Like, I don't think you're really gonna get double Priest or Priest Steward off very often. So I think I'm leaning slightly towards Steward. It seems like that's the general agreement in the chat as well. Oh, that's true. We do have the coffers, so I guess double T map. Yeah, not sure about that one. I mean, there is maybe a set your double T map works with encampments, but I feel like with stockpile in there and other stuff, it's just not worth the risk.
Yeah, I mean, let's say it works and you collide them, shuffle one of them. What are you buying for?
Yeah, I mean, I could. Maybe see one where you actually get two later on, potentially. Like, once you have deck control, I could see treasure maps making sense, and then because then you have the stockpile ones. Yeah, I'm not sure if you need potion on this board. I don't really see it being super strong. Aglet went for it. Aglet did go for the uni, whereas Rosie did go for the stockpile that we preferred, I think. Yeah, I don't think it's actively bad, but, I mean, I think if you have enough, you'd want to pair it with a bunch of stewards for draw. So here, Rosie with four. What are you getting with four here is Rosie? That's, I guess, another steward. I guess you're just making that for the draw later. But then, I mean, I guess you have the ports for villages. I guess that's true. Steward uni is technically a net zero. Not sure. I really like the encampment from Rosie there. I mean, I guess she only had two, so I guess it makes sense. Yeah, I was just saying I wasn't sure that I saw they only had two, and I was like, okay, that makes sense. Yeah, which still makes sense. Yeah, I think you're right. I think that would have been better. And here, yeah, you get to trash. Now, do you go team map here, Rosie? Do you start thinking about that, or is it too early? I think that's reasonable. With only one stockpile in exile, like, I'm not sure what you're doing with the stockpiles there, so I think it's definitely fair. Yeah, I mean, it looks like they're kind of just not playing the stockpile game very much. So now here is where I would think about double treasure map here for Rosie. I guess you want to exile the stockpiles, but I think. Oh, you could still do double. Yeah, you are true that university can be awkward when you don't have much draw here. Like, what are you gonna do? And I'm not sure what you really like. What are you gaining with the five gem? I mean, he's beginning bakers, which are like fine, but aren't really great. And I think he's been abandoning stockpiles, which are generally quite powerful to do that. Little Andy is apparently not a uni fan. Yeah, I mean, but look at like, yeah, and and this sort of board, I agree though. Like, look at Rosie's just basically able to almost draw deck already. Just between stewards and ports, and is already very thin. Yeah, I mean, you have all the stockpiles. Like, you could just basically, like, Aglet's not even really contesting the stockpiles. Yeah, definitely not. I think you have to probably just take a. Does he have stockpiles in exile? It doesn't look like it. Did he not get any stockpiles? No, he definitely had one earlier. I'm just trying to figure out why it wasn't in exile. I guess he discarded it prior to in that shuffle still. Bit of a dead turn for Rosie there, but now should have a very strong turn here. And the piles are already getting pretty low. I mean, Steward stockpile port is a very quick pile out. Like, Rosie could have a pile out pretty soon here. Yeah, I agree. I mean, most of the benefit of uni is getting a bunch of quick, like, a good 5 cost cards out, and I don't think this is set where there's really any super expensive cards you need to be gaining with uni that you can't just be getting otherwise. Yeah, I definitely agree that at this point you don't want the potion. I don't. Rosie, like, almost has a. I mean, Rosie's, like, pretty close to having a pile out. Like, I would not be surprised if she had a pile out next turn. In fact, I would be pretty surprised if she doesn't have a pile out next turn. I mean, you're only going to need 6, 9. I'm not sure I like the province. I honestly probably would have just gotten, like, an estate and then just lowered some of the piles. I mean, I guess you do have to then worry with 3 universities about Aglet piling out, but I think you're just going for pile out next turn if you're Rosie, so I think you take... I guess you take double port here. Yeah. I mean, I think the plan is basically Rosie has a pile out next turn. It's just trying to make sure she gets the pile out next turn. Yeah, I think I probably would have gone, like, you could have gone double port stockpile duchy, maybe. I mean, I would have gotten at least one. I think I would have. I don't know. Actually, I'm not sure you really need any victory points. I think I would have probably just tried to get. Yeah. I mean, piles are low enough, but I think you could have probably saved the next turn for your victory points. But maybe you're worried that, you know, with the universities, that's going to run a risk of Aglet getting a pile out. But, yeah, Rosie should have a pile out this turn. I mean, she only needs 8. What's that? She only needs 4, 7, 10, 13 for a pile out. For the 1 port, 2 stockpiles steward. Has 6 in hand. So I think it's got to be reasonably likely, because pretty much your entire deck is stewards and stockpiles and ports, so there's not really many dud cards there. And I don't think Aglet might be able to get a province, but even if Aglet gets a province, I think Rosie should still be able to. I mean, just has to get 1 extra estate, so it still only needs 15 for a pile out. So 15 and 3, so what's that, 3, 4, 5 buys is a pile out here. I think you have to take the 2 cards here, steward. I mean, I guess you could just take the province and play it safe, but... yeah, and there's going to be the pile out now. I mean, I guess still technically needs to draw 1 more stockpile here. There we go, there's the pile out. Good game to Rosie. That's a she's up 3-0. Win is player 2 here again. So going into the last game is P1 with 3 victories in hand.
I have returned.
Rosie has a pile out, assuming that she sees it, which I'm pretty sure she does. Yep.
Rosie playing excellent.
Yeah, Rosie. That was a very well played game by Rosie, and the double tack that we both thought was kind of awkward. We're still not 100% sure it's the right strategy, but I feel like she did execute it very well.
Definitely. And at levels like this...
And the first game, I mean, they both just went for familiar, and she got... I mean, she got lucky, but it's not like she didn't make any mistakes in there either.
Agreed. And a lot of the time at this level, like, execution is the big design. You know, 2 players could pick different game plans, and maybe, like, we agree to see who should win, and, like, the perfect play. But at this level, it's just about, like,
Even Aglet giving the compliment in chat. You like to see that, you know, good sportsmanship. They're both obviously people around. Yeah, you're right that, as we mentioned, we like the silver game 1, so a little bit of luck game 1 for sure from Rosie, but I do think, you know, played that board very well. Definitely built a really good engine there. Yeah, like, I don't think a lot of players at this level, I'm not sure I would have seen that, the camel train to get the extra familiars. Like, that was something that I think a lot of, would have been an easy something to miss, and something that Rosie did see well and play well. So anyways, on to game number 4. We'll see if Rosie can get the queen sweep here. Yeah, which is true.
Making
Yeah, I mean, the amulet does give two trashes, so that definitely does help prevent
Yeah.
that.
If it goes great with Curcure.
Would
I
you.
think I'm opening Money Lender Amulet, not a Warlord here, just because the fives aren't that inspiring on their own first shuffle.
So they both end up going Patron Amulet. I'm not sure about the idea of Patron
I'm
here.
convinced by the
Like,
patron.
I don't know what
Patron
good the
is like
villagers. Yeah, I'm not really sure how strong the villagers are here.
It's good to have a buffer of villagers. That's definitely strong in Fey in general. But it's not like I'm dying to hit five here. I'd rather Amulet Money Lender
Yeah, I feel like
than
Moneylender's a better copper trasher than Amulet is.
Definitely.
Yeah, I could see the argument for Amulet Overlord.
Curcure either Amulet Money Lender or Double.
I think I'd prefer Amulet Moneylender over Double Amulet, but it looks like they're both going a second patron, it looks like. So they both are really strong on the patron this game. I mean, I guess it could help to just be able to have a bunch of extra actions, but like, I don't really know what terminals. I mean, you have some amulets, but outside of that, I don't think you're gonna
Is
have
there
a
like
lot.
Building Party here that I'm missing?
I
Is
mean, I
there
guess library, like, could
a
be.
library reveal? Oh, that would be terrifying. Look at that.
It doesn't say reveal. I would have thought it does, but you're right that it does not say
Also a
reveal.
weird base set wording.
That's true. Overlord could be Cursed Villages, which could be. I think that's probably a better way than Patron. I mean, I definitely think you want draw. I mean, if you're going Patron, I think you definitely want to be going library. Like.
I mean, I think Cursed Village and Library both work just fine with draw decks on the stack for Patron.
Yeah, exactly. I think. But I think you definitely want library. I would have probably taken library over Cursed Village there as I guess Aglet. I think you have the villagers to play one or two of the libraries, and then you get the Cursed Village after.
You would be really likely to miss. Also, wow, look at those coffers from the tavern.
That's a nice curse, a nice hex. Look at that.
You like two free coffers?
I mean, Rosie's playing well, and even the hexes are helping her out. Good day for Rosie, I guess.
They removed their hexes and the hexes don't matter.
Yeah, I definitely think. Yeah, I'm definitely surprised that they both went double Cursed Village and haven't gotten libraries yet. Like, I feel like with all these patrons, I would have taken library before probably even the first Cursed Village.
I mean, I don't really think library is particularly better than Cursed Village either.
I mean, it's
Cursed
just
Village is
draw,
like
like, and
two
you.
cards.
Yeah, I guess that's true. I guess Cursed Village is also draw. And I guess neither one's going Overlord. Which, I mean, at this point is probably reasonable. I definitely think there was a. I would be
I think
curious to
the
have seen
hexes
the
here
Overlord
are
opener.
not long enough. They're going to be able to afford Overlord. So they're going to start making more sense than more Cursed Villages or.
Yeah, 'cause I mean there is no extra buys, so
Yeah, if
that
you
is
have zero
something to
extra, you
consider.
can go for Overlord.
Yeah, I mean if you have eight, there's literally I don't think there's any reason not to get an Overlord and to buy a different action, right? Like, I can't
Yeah, I
think
mean,
of any
Overlord can
reason.
play everything on this board except for
You,
Devil.
what do you think? How early is it to green? Is it?
It's too early to green. I want to build it all the more. I feel like if I green. The thing about draw to X decks is they totally choke on green. So
Yeah.
you want to build a decent amount because your deck is really going to slow down if you have a lot of draw pieces
Yeah, I
left.
think I definitely like Overlord here for Aglet. Like, I don't. That's true. Windfall is actually an option here. That is true.
The problem is it also does not go with the draw to X deck.
But, I mean, at the same time, I think Windfall is actually reasonably viable there. Like, I think it's going to allow you to pretty reliably hit 8. Like, if you Windfall there.
You're clogging up your deck with bolts. You're all of a sudden gonna hit these situations, one or two provinces in, where you draw a hand of like two provinces, a gold, two golds, and a
That's fair. Yeah, Aglet has done a really good job of getting this deck clean. I mean, I guess you probably take one more Overlord here and then you start greening, probably. Yeah, I'm not sure what else you need from it. An Overlord, you're literally giving yourself a curse and, like, your deck less flexible. And you have four villagers. It's not even like you need the it's not even like you need the actions from Cursed Village. Like, I'd rather, even if you want something to just draw, I'd rather take a library there than a Cursed Village at this point. Yeah, and like you don't get the hex. So even if you're not buying Overlord for some reason.
Well, why are you not buying Overlord?
Yeah, I agree. I mean, I don't know why you're not buying Overlord. I mean, I don't think Aglet needs his moneylender because I think he's like out of copper. So Rosie does start greening. Probably fair. I mean, it's a little risky, but I think she probably has to take that gamble here. I mean, Aglet's still ahead because of the minus victory points from the hex. Aglet's ahead if they just both province every turn. I think Aglet's deck is strong enough to probably just buy the four provinces here. Yep, I agree. Yeah, Aglet should have this one, I think. I don't see much of a comeback here from Rosie. Just didn't play the amulet. Yeah, that seems a little odd to have not played it. I don't see the reason not to play it. Like, at worst case scenario, you just get one money next turn and you have a card you aren't plugged. You don't have to worry about drawing next turn. For sure. And she realized it right away. Yeah, I mean, basically it's just, is Aglet gonna dud? Is basically the name of this game. And I think their deck is strong enough. I think it's fairly unlikely. But you never know. I mean, they do have to pretty much draw a deck to get to 8. Not sure. I guess they have the action, the villagers, so it doesn't matter. I was about to say they messed up by playing the action, you know, the non-terminal first,
yeah.
But I guess it doesn't matter. Yeah, I mean, because especially the other thing is Aglet can just keep sea hagging, which is also pretty strong. Yeah. I'm not sure. I wonder if an opening of it could have worked. I don't know.
It's not like bad. I just think that like in the opening you're not as quick to hit 5 and the 5 effects aren't particularly strong in the opening.
That is true.
Draw, not, like, dying from
you'd
draw
probably rather, yeah, I think you have a good point. Just thin first and then get overload it like, you know, maybe the second or third shuffle. I mean, yeah, because, yeah, I just don't think there's much of a chance of Aglet dudding, although this is sort of hand, I mean, you really only need one. I mean, I guess you would need two at this point. Yeah, you would need two, and it's not going to happen, so. So that's probably going to be a 3-1, so that definitely makes this group interesting. You know, puts Aglet at 4-4, puts Rosie up now to 7-5. I'm sitting at 5-3, so definitely gonna be a tight group. I mean, I guess Rosie's in pretty good shape because I still have to play Aglet, so one of us will have to go down. And then we still have a player that hasn't played at all yet.
Let's see what happens. Rosie provinces, Aglet hags and provinces back, and then Rosie can't take the last province.
I mean, I still think Rosie probably doesn't have any choice but to province here and just hope that Aglet does. Like, I don't think Rosie really has any choice. But yeah, I mean, you just Aglet, you get the amulet for money, then you play the Cursed Village for draw, and then... That was an interesting decision. I don't know why you would bother trashing a copper here. I mean, I guess you get the draw with Cursed Village, so I guess it makes some sense, because you do get the draw with Cursed Village. I don't know about that decision, though. That might have just cost Aglet the game. I don't know if you just muted again. But yeah, you muted again, KHG. But
no, yeah, I need to take a step away.
Oh, you're good. Yeah, Aglet didn't curse there. I mean, I think Aglet's still in fine, like, still likely gonna win because Aglet can still just province here. So I guess in some ways this might actually be the safer line because, like, if you Duchy dance, you're good. Yeah, that's what we were wondering, Halo. We don't know. But I mean, like, Rosie can't really take a province here unless really just hope for the dud. I mean, I almost feel like Rosie has to hope for the dud and just take a province there, as risky as it is. I mean, I feel like, I don't know, I guess if you're Duchy dancing, maybe Rosie feels like her deck is going to hold up better with the coffers and stuff. Yeah, but now Aglet can just province.
Now province is totally safe.
Do what we wanted last turn, basically. I mean, I guess it's not totally safe. Well, I mean, I don't know how it's not totally safe. Like, what?
Safe because...
No, I mean, Halo is saying it's not safe. But Rosie doesn't have... The thing is, Rosie's player one, so... Like, Rosie doesn't have it, and there's no extra ways to get buys.
Rosie could trash curse.
Oh, that's... Does she have any curses left?
She just did.
Oh, she must have gained one. Yeah, you're right. So, I guess Aglet's smarter than we are, then. I guess that's why... Yeah, well played by Aglet. I missed that one. Rosie, yes, I guess Aglet just has to keep Duchy dancing then. I mean, obviously knowing Rosie's hand, he could province there and win. Actually, no, not, because Rosie still has the coffers, so never mind. So now the question is, does Rosie risk a province here? I mean, if you Duchy, you just know Aglet's going to get the last Duchy, right?
Yep.
But I guess he's still... I mean, I don't think your next hand's going to be very... I guess it's a question of how good Rosie's next hand going to be. I mean, you think they're collapsing, but they've hit 8, like, pretty much every turn still. I mean, yeah, basically the way I was to get both the last two provinces at this point.
Yeah. What's the last province? Don't they have another province coming?
I only see 2, and they should have 3, so yeah, I believe it was. Yeah, I mean, Rosie basically has to be able to get both the last two provinces here, which I think is quite unlikely. I mean, I guess 1-1... guests just have to buy an estate? I don't know. I'm not even sure it really helps. Makes sense. That's true, archive probably would have been fine. They would have had to spend a coffer, so I'm not sure it would have been worth it. Yeah, this is, these decks are really dead. Yeah, I don't like the estate buy. You definitely, I think you should be going, I think as Aglet, are you probably just trying to pile at that point? Like, go patron and then just sea hag the last few curses? I feel like that's what I'd be doing as Aglet there. Yeah, all these green cards, yeah, are super awkward now.
Yeah, I think I would have played with the word of patron in the previous turn and tried to hit eight. Kaplan, I played a great archive game today where archive was like my only draw. It was very enjoyable. It was like a very money-ish game.
I don't know, maybe you should have had Crypt if it was a money-ish game instead. Yeah, we'll see. I mean, yeah, I'm not sure, you're right. I'm not sure either one of them's gonna hit 8 again. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, I think you just start going for the pileout as Aglet here, I think. I think I'd be taking Patron there. Rosie might get a, actually Rosie will get a province here. I mean, at this point you buy a province, obviously. No, yeah, you're right. The Aglet definitely should have gotten one there over the Peddler. I mean, Rosie's. I mean, I feel like you have to buy a province as Rosie. I don't know.
Yeah, there's no decision here. I think Rosie's just looking at the game.
I mean, maybe try to figure out deck, like maybe trying to calculate Aglet's deck here. You might be able to see, you know, if you see the Aglet actually does have a bunch of strong cards down, then maybe, but, I mean, I don't. Yeah, I mean, even if Aglet, like, if Aglet gets the province here.
What? Rosie bought another hag? That's.
That seems. Yeah. That definitely seems questionable.
If she just took that province, then she was in a really good position to take the last province. Aglet's deck is stalling, and she has those coffers.
Yeah, I mean, maybe she miscalculated Aglet's deck and thought Aglet was, like, guaranteed the province this turn or something. Yeah, I don't know why you aren't, I mean, I feel like Patron is good. I would have, like I said, been still just going for the pile outs. Ooh, now a Nosey didn't get to 8 again this time. Now I don't really know what you do.
Okay.
Yeah, that's true. I guess Rosie doesn't want complain as a friend, I guess.
See, yeah, it seems
Yeah, I mean, I feel like there's not that many curses left. Yeah, like, especially because you already have two, what is the third one gonna do? Like, I mean, I guess Rosie's thinking you just give two curses, and then eventually, if you pile out, you actually are ahead. Yeah, it's an interesting board, Maka. That's for sure. They opened very heavy on patrons and then hit provinces a bunch and then duchy danced and then now can't do anything. Ooh, that was a good, nice draw for that cursed village there. And the sea hag's actually really nice here because that actually puts Rosie ahead here. So do you patron here as Rosie now? I don't know if you want to use.
Yeah, I don't think I have any plus buy.
I mean, you do use both coffers. I guess it would depend what your last five cards are. I mean, it's gotta be. I feel like I would have calculated my deck, and given this deck, which I think you could have calculated, I would have definitely used the two coffers to patron there, I think. Eglet just resigns. All right, I don't know why
Yeah,
you
I
res
lose.
yeah.
Love that one back. Rip victory from the jaws of defeat.
Yeah, that was very well played by Rosie. A 4-0 definitely puts her in really good shape to make the finals. I mean, 8-4 now. So, with a decent result in her last match, will definitely be in really good shape to make the finals. Yep, thanks, KHG.
I have to go be in the tournament.
Sounds good. Thanks, KHG. I'll talk to you later.
See ya.
Thanks, everyone, for listening.